This week, the media has been filled with all forms of photos of the good and bad in our health system in what we called Uganda Health Exhibition. Today in our News Digest, we speak to Emmanuel Ainebiona, the spokesperson for the Ministry of Health, to understand whether such an exhibition makes sense to the ministry.
Is an important point for feedback to the government and also to the Ministry of Health on the service delivery on the healthcare system. Because the healthcare system is broad and sometimes we are not everywhere. So if there is feedback about some gaps, then it is incumbent upon us as the Ministry of Health working with the entire government to reflect on the gaps that have been raised through this ongoing exhibition. But as the Ministry of Health also, it's an opportunity for us to showcase what has been done, the achievements in the sector, because there has been a tremendous effort in improving Uganda's healthcare system. For instance, to do with vaccination, we do not have people now suffering from polio. And those are success stories of the immunization program. In terms of handling emerging and re-emerging diseases, a case in point for the COVID-19, Uganda was lauded globally and was number one on the African continent as far as combating the pandemic of COVID was concerned. We were able to handle the recent Ebola outbreak in Mubende in record time. So those are some things Ugandans also should appreciate. So we really are looking and following closely on the issues being raised. If the exhibitors, for instance, are pointing to the issue of extortion within the public health facilities, then as the ministry we should address this issue of extortion.
According to Ainebiona, the ministry does not need such exhibitions to wake up and work, but the health ministry has achieved a lot that Ugandans need to appreciate.
No. This has been ongoing. The exhibition is not even a week old. So, because I'm telling you what we have been able to do. So, government is doing whatever it takes to ensure that the issues that Ugandans are raising or Ugandans have been raising are addressed. But also this has to do with the availability of resources. We can only go a mile based on the resources available. Because as you understand, the funding to the health sector should at least be 15% of the national budget as per the Abuja declaration. But we haven't gotten to that.
On the issue of interns, Ainebiona says the ministry is waiting on the cabinet and the interns should be patient.
It gets back to the available enough resources, but also we have realized that the numbers of interns coming out of universities keeps growing. So the reason why now they have not been deployed is that there are discussions at the higher government level to ensure that we have adequate resources to cater for them. And that's why basically they have not reported. And these are pre-interns. They haven't started their internship, so you cannot refer to them as interns, but they are pre-interns. But we hope that cabinet will have a solution in the shortest possible time.
When asked about the doctor-patient ratio, Ainebiona had this to say.
But all this, I have said, are dependent on the resources you have as a country. Because if we are not collecting as much revenue, you have to ensure that you work and provide services within the means you are able to offer. But the good news is that now at least our health workers' salaries have been enhanced. So we hope that as we go on and get more budgets and resources, we will be able to see the impact of this increment in terms of the attitude, in terms of the attendance to duty, and also ensuring that the patients are able to appreciate Yes, some Ugandans appreciate when you go even into the exhibition. It's a mixed bag of reactions. There are those ones who are appreciative of the services. There are also those ones who have been frustrated while accessing services. And at the end of the day, as government, we'll work towards ensuring that at least everyone's concerns are listened to, and at least we find lasting solutions to these concerns.